all the awesome moves you can expect from someone riding the bowl. And when you see a kid riding this high, you can't imagine how skateboarding could get any better. That is, until you meet Rodney Mullen, the 1982 freestyle skateboarding champion. A professional at 16, he's bringing a whole new dimension to what you can do with a skateboard on a sidewalk or in your own backyard. And today, with his sponsor, Stacy Peralta, he's going to show us some of the tricks that have earned him a world championship.
Let me see what you got planned so far for the contest.
Okay.
This is a two-minute routine, right?
One and a half, because
okay.
We're
going
to change it. Freestyle, you kind of have to take one step at a time, so you can't go straight into big tricks. So it takes a lot of preparation. Sometimes in pool riding, you can pretty much go straight at it.
We've been taking him around town and showing him, just having public demonstrations. And I've never seen the public get so enthralled and enthused by watching a skateboarder before. And that includes, you know, pool riders and everything. There's something he's doing that's different. He's offering a different approach than I've ever seen done before. And the average person on the street usually looks at it and goes, oh, I see, that's interesting. But now they're kind of going, this is unbelievable. I mean, there's something here that we've never seen before. And it's more than just the skating. It's just the attitude. It's the whole package.
Rodney has quite an impressive list of titles as winner of the 1980 Oasis Pro-Am, the 1981 Magic Mountain Pro-Am, and this year's Rusty Harris Series. And after 5 years of constant practice, Rodney can tell you firsthand what it's been like to break ground in a new area.
Self-discipline, I guess. That's the biggest thing. Just pushing yourself out there sometimes. If you're tired, you still gotta go out. And sometimes you hurt yourself, like a lot of bruises, but you can't stop.
He practices in his garage, I think up to 5 to 6 hours a day, anywhere from, you know, none to 8 hours. And he puts so much time, and his demands of himself are incredible. He's got incredible demands on himself. So he just pushes himself to do it.
Stacy knows all about dedication to this sport. He was a professional himself at 16 and competed for 7 years, winning many national championships. 2 years ago, he was voted Skateboarder of the Year. And now he has taken Rodney under his wing to help him maintain his world title.
It's like most people look at a champion and they go, God, what a great life, this and that. But it's really a lot of work. You know, the hard part, even harder than getting to be number one, is staying to be number one. Is being there and staying there, and that's when the real stamina and the real professionalism comes out in a person. That's when it gets tough.
Rodney's become so well known in the last year that he even has a skateboard named after him. It's manufactured through Peralta's company, and both the board and Rodney draw crowds wherever they go.
There are not that many people who really go for freestyle, just trick, trick, trick. They usually just skate around. So that's really unusual to them, I guess. 260 boards, they have small wheels, and they have not quite as much tail and nose as a freestyle board. And this is the main difference in a 360 board, a lot less friction when you spin. And freestyle boards, they're much smaller than like pool boards, and that's so you can flip them around, because pool boards, you need stability and everything. And really tight trucks, so you land solid whatever you do. And long tail, long nose, so you can flip it. Like, just really quick.
It takes a lot of practice. It's very difficult. I mean, what he's doing is, it's the state of the art in freestyle.
For For a couple of years, the popularity of skateboarding was going downhill fast. But thanks to kids like Rodney and enthusiasts like Stacy, skateboarding has developed into a sport for everybody that can be done anywhere.